News today is about John Podito. He's a guy from South Jersey. He's facing 20 years in prison for growing 17 pot plants in his backyard. As you know, I have not been a proponent of legalizing pot until this case just kind of hits everybody in the face. And I think, what are we doing?
I'm surprised it took you this long to come around. I mean, and you said back when you were younger, you said, oh, you legalize it.
Yeah, I went
through
that
phase. Then you got married and had kids, and then you changed, like, oh, we have a drug problem.
Yeah.
Keep it illegal.
Well, we do have a drug problem, though.
We do, of course.
We got a heroin problem, but we have a prescription drug problem, too.
You know where to get yourself some weed?
I don't.
Okay, I don't either. Right. But you know who does? Your 12-year-old son. Because there's a black market.
Of course.
You get rid of the black market when you legalize it.
Yeah.
It's not like, and I'm not a pothead, I'm not a pot smoker, it doesn't do anything for me.
But for
years, I couldn't understand why people, like Prohibition, it took 10 years and finally the country
woke up. Well, we had talked about this. I mean, it's like, you know, the government, I think, has completely overstepped their bounds in making it illegal.
Absolutely.
And now the states are having this backlash, but they're still under this threat. I brought it up earlier that you know, two things. One, that we're using law enforcement resources to go grab a guy that's growing pot in his backyard. Outrageous. Cops have better things to do than
Absolutely.
That.
Absolutely.
And number two, it's now on the jury. You know, back in colonial days, I mean, the last bastion of protecting our liberty was the jury.
Right.
And it's come that way again. And I think these 12 members of the jury have an opportunity. They call a jury nullification. They can throw the thing out, even though the guy admits that he did it.
And one of the reasons why we're not coming to our senses like we did back in Prohibition is because Big Pharma, and God bless them, they come up with cures for diseases and things. Nothing against Big Pharma, but they lobby hard against it because they don't want the competition.
Right.
And that's sad. So it is left to the people.
Well, we've said this. If Big Pharma can't compete with the guy growing a couple plants in his backyard, then they've got a much bigger problem.
But if everybody does that, they see it as a big threat.
Well,
we're stuck in this horrible position.
But the other thing that never gets talked about is some of this cannabis oil. It doesn't get you high. Parents give it to their kids and it stops seizures.
It doesn't have THC, which is the chemical that gets you high. CBD, I think, is what the chemical that actually does something beneficial. So we agree on this.
All right, Dennis and I on the same page with legalizing pot. It's time to get this out of the government's hands. They have absolutely wrecked it in terms of medical marijuana distribution in this state. Now it's time to get this. First of all, acquit this guy and send him on his way back to his pot plants.
We gotta follow
and second of all, legalize pot across the board. It's time.